Today we are going to learn about the chapter Token, which is a important chapter in the programming language like Java and C++. Here we see that here we are given with a program, Java program, class simple. Here we can write a program, but every word here, class public static void main string arg system dot out dot println. Every word class public static void main has a specific meaning. And now if we move to the example of the C++ program, here we see that this program is written, but what does this word means? Here we are going to learn about tokens. What is tokens? Let us learn about this. And here we will also learn the keyword identifier, literal and punctuators and operators meaning. So let's start. Here every word in the program is a token. That means it has a special meaning given in the programming language. Here we see that token is the smallest individual unit in a program. Here if we write a program, this is the individual unit, a word, any word. It has a special meaning in the programming language as void main. This is the return type and this is the function's name. Now what is all that? Let's learn here. Now here token. Token are of five types. First is keyword. Second is identifier. Third is literal and fourth is punctuator, which are also called separators, and fifth is operators. So let's see what are these all. Keywords are special words with special meanings. It means that as we see the example in the program, this class public static void main, this every word has a special meaning in the programming language, whether it is in Java or C++, it has some special meaning. These all are a keyword. Now, let's see. Keywords are the word that conveys a special meaning to the programming compiler. These are reserved for special purpose and are not to be used for normal identifier. Here, identifier means that it is the class name or a variable name. Later we will be discussing about what is class and variable. So example of keyword: abstract, default, if, boolean, do, else, etc. So these are some of the examples, and now on the screen you can see many more examples of keywords. These all are examples of keywords. So please take a screenshot. Now let's move to the next token, that is identifier. These are normally used named as class name or variable name. So what are these? See, here We have class simple. Simple is the name of the class. And here we have no variable. Afterwards, I will show you what is variable. So identify our fundamental building block of a program and are used to be as general technological names given to variables, functions, array, class, etc. So it is a technical name. If we are storing the height of a person, so we are taking the variable name as height, that is written. Now I am showing you example. What are the what should be an identifier's rule, means how the name of a variable should follow. It can have alphabet, digit, and alphabet, digit, and underscore, and dollar sign character. So it can only contain all of this. It must not begin with a digit. That means the name of the class in Java should not start with a digit, or a variable's name should not start with a digit, and it can be of any length. So the length of the variable's name is not fixed, or a class name. It can be of any length. It must not be a keyword, as I said before, or boolean literal, or a null literal. Now, after that, uppercase and lowercase are treated differently. Example, if we take a variable's name as simple and in lowercase like this, simple, these are treated as different. Means if there are variable name as simple of uppercase and simple of lowercase, then they would be treated as different variables. Now we go to the next token, that is literal. The value supported by the programming language. It means literals are the constant. For example, if we are taking an value, that is our age. If our age is 1, 2, 3, so literal is integer literal. That means integer literal can save this value, and that value is known as literal. Now, we see here, literal often referred to as constant are data item that are fixed values. That means the value of 1, 2, 3, these are constant. These are the values which can be assigned as a variable of that data type. Now, let's see how many type of literals are. First type of literal is integeral literals. That means it contains decimal. Decimal means all the numbers, and octadecimal. Afterwards, I will explain you the meaning of octa and hexadecimal. These are all numbers. Now let's see the next literal. So floating literal, it means that it includes real fractions. It means it floating literals can hold the real values, means 2. If we are assigning the value 2, we have to assign it as 2.0, as it is storing the fractional values. 3.5, these are the examples. Now boolean literal, this literal can store only 2 values, true and false, nothing else. That means it is a condition checking literal. Now, character literal, it is called one character. That means character literal can store any character or alphabets or any special symbol that are falling in characters. It can contain string. That means it is containing strings. That means ABC, it is a string or a word. See, Ramu, any name, or Charlie. So this is a name containing literal. Null literal. Null means it is nothing. If a variable is not assigned with any value, then it is null. It means if any value in a program is not assigned with any value and you try to print the value, it shows a error. That means that the value is null and it cannot be shown. Now, separators. These are the separators. In programming, we see these symbols. These have some special meaning to the programming language. And operators. Now, operators are something like addition, subtraction, and many more things like logical gates and all that. Separators are symbols that initiates action. Some of the operators are. Now in this screen, you can see some operators and examples of some operators. And if you like this video, please share it, like it, and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching the video.